time, is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. You know just where it's at. Right down there. Right down there. And it's time to follow my Instagram. That's Geekly Amanda. G-E-E-K-L-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. Make sure to follow me there too. It's time to get this movie review started. Screener for the new Marvel's Black Widow, finally out after many, many months, almost a year, it feels like, of delays. And it's coming to theaters and on Disney Plus with the premium access next week, Friday, July 9th. First, let me give you a little synopsis of what the movie's about. So Black Widow takes place, you know, right after Civil War, the Captain America Civil War, where, you know, Black Widow joined forces with Captain America, and now they, you know, are kind of on the run and in hiding. And so we get to kind of see what happens while Black Widow, Natasha Romanoff, is in hiding. And it starts off, though, it kind of goes back in time, gives a little, you know, intro to her younger years, a younger Natasha, back in 1995. And she was living in Ohio with her mom and dad and sister. And, you know, something crazy happened and they had to evacuate, and they flew off to like this camp where they took her and her sister. They took them both, trained them to be assassins. And we kind of, you know, see what happens to her sister, and what they do, you know, with these assassins that they call Widow. Now, although this movie's based on Black Widow, I'm going to tell you, I was so obsessed with her sister, Yelena, is it called, played by Florence Pugh. I was obsessed. She, like, stole the show. First of all, the chemistry between the two is great. They have great chemistry. They play sisters, and you kind of have that feel like, you know, they poke fun of each other. They believable sisters. One of my favorite parts was when she talks about, you know, Black Widow's pose, fighting pose, when she crouches down on the floor and flips her hair back up, and she kind of like recreates that little pose, you know, kind of razzing, you know, Natasha a bit, and called her a poser, and then she kept bringing the poser up throughout the show. I mean, the laughs between those two, the chemistry between those two, when the two were on screen together, I loved it, but I have to admit that Florence Pugh kind of outshined her at times. I was like, she's stealing the show over here. She wasn't the only one bringing the kind of comedy. You know, who plays the Red Guardian, the David Harbour, is that how you call it? He had me cracking up too. His funny little witty quips and when he gets back in his Red Guardian suit, I mean, I think they had that scenes in the trailer. I was cracking up. Even the way he was like flirting with Melina? Played by Rachel Weisz. She played kind of the mother figure to them. And, you know, he was kind of just flirting and all with her. I thought it was adorable, but he really brought the other comedy in this. I appreciated all the comedy in these Marvel films. So when they come and really bring the laughs and everything, I am there for it. I admit, the timing feels off. I mean, it was delayed a year. But also, you know, we've already had WandaVision. We already had The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. We already had, well, currently have Loki, which is all series, you know, in the Marvel, this phase four of the Marvel Cinematic Universe that kind of brings the story, brings it forward. And now we're getting a story, you know, an origin story, which, hello, I mean, it's important for Black Widow to have her own little origin story, but it just feels late. You know, and I know it's not all Marvel's fault. There was delayed and everything, but it really doesn't bring the story forward. You're kind of just stuck in that time where like, oh yeah, it's enjoyable. Believe me, I loved it. I thought it was completely enjoyable, but no one, even her fate, you're just kind of like, okay. It's hard to get invested in it and invested in these characters when you already kind of know the fate of Natasha and Black Widow. You have an end credit scene. So you're like, oh, is some of these characters going to be used in the future? It really gets your mind wondering. It gets it racing. You know, even though Natasha is gone, will all these other characters be used? Will they use Yelena? Will they use the Red Guardian? Or will they use even the villain in this, Taskmaster? Who knows? I was disappointed about the villain, Taskmaster. I kind of hope they don't use it. It was such a cool villain. It could be such a cool villain. Like when I first saw it, my husband was like, Taskmaster! And by the end, he was like, oh, Taskmaster. I mean, they have the power to mirror and fight and mirror the scenes you fight. And they showed that some. But I wanted more. It just kind of felt like such a weak villain to me when it could have been a great one. The only other complaint in this was the length of the movie. I've preached about it before, these 2 hours plus minute movies that don't need to be it. And this is one also. I mean, I was invested, like, watching it in the action. I was into it. But I'm going to tell you, by, like, the third act, you felt the length. And you were like, all right, when's this going to be over? Even though that was, like, the peak of when they're going to really fight and the villain and the heroes come, you know. That was, like, the climax of the movie. You're like, I'm ready for it to be over with. Because it's just too long! All my complaints are kind of minuscule in the big picture. This is a Marvel film, you know, they do it right. They keep you entertained. It's an enjoyable ride. I enjoyed it. I will watch it again. I'd like to see it on the big screen. I just got a screener because those action scenes, the CG, all of that on point, of course, because I wouldn't expect any less from Marvel. Now let's talk about what parents need to know before they allow their kids to watch Black Widow. First, the language. I mean, you're going to have some harsh words. It is PG-13. You get your S word. You even get, like, I think one B word. You know, you get your damns and what else? Your GDs. You got, you know, goddamns and stuff. But it's not going to have any really harsh stuff where, like, the F word is used or anything like that. Of course, the other content, the mature content you have to look out is, like, the violence. It's a Marvel film. You're going to get shootouts, hand-to-hand combat, stabbings, you know, gunshot wounds, deaths from it. You know, this is going to be an intense, explosions. It's going to be an intense, like, violent type of film. It also has kind of, like, that dark side. Like I said, girls are kidnapped, and some from, like, homes, happy homes, their mothers, and given to, you know, these people to train them to be, like, some sort of assassin. So there's kind of like this child trafficking thing going on. I mean, it's going to have its dark side in that respect, though. It's Black Widow. It's Marvel. They're back. You're going to like, yeah, I'm telling you, any kind of fan of the superhero films is going to enjoy this one. I sure did. And you have the choice to watch it in theaters, which I would choose. I mean, who doesn't want to watch this film on the big screen? And on Disney Plus with Premier Access. You know, it comes out next week, Friday, July 9th. Let me know what you think. If you're excited for it or anything else, comments, thumbs, and all that. Till next time. Mwah.